Hello there. I'm on the draw in the finals in game two. And this hand is fantastic. Hopefully I draw a two drop, but even without one, this hand is great. I'm going to play the flock on turn three. So that is the least valuable morph, I think. With the intention to cast the knuckle blade later. At least that's what I think I'm going to do. I might just cast the knuckle blade on turn three. Ooh, Mantis Rider. I guess maybe my opponent was passing to me in the draft, also opened a Mantis Rider. Alright, this is an unorthodox play. I'm just going to completely bluff and hope that my opponent doesn't block. That's right. Taste your two damage. I had nothing. Over the course of playing a lot of Magic, I've discovered that bluffs often do not work. However, when your opponent has a rare creature and limited, they often overvalue it just because it's rare. So every time my opponent plays a rare creature and I have the opportunity to bluff, I'm very likely to take it. As opposed to if the creature is just a normal creature, I'm very unlikely to bluff. Classic bell strike on my knuckle blade. That's really not that threatening. I can just return the knuckle blade to my hand. I just need to survive up until that point. I guess since my hand is so good, I'm just gonna try to wait this out. And I'm just gonna play the flock and then choose to block. I'll block with my flock. I could have used Savage Punch, but I had a strange feeling that my opponent had Feat of Resistance. Alright. I don't know what to do, and all my opponents open mana. It's kind of frightening me. I'm just going to cast the Canyon Lurker's face up. Alright, my opponent had Bring Low for the Lurkers. That's fine. Wow, double Bell Strike. Okay. So I could just bounce the knuckle blade and replay it this turn. Though I'm under a lot of pressure. I could also just untap the flock and block. Alright. I'm not really sure if this is best. I'm really scared of this two mana. I feel like my opponent has Feat of Resistance, or maybe just a Force Away, but this turn I'm going to untap the flock. My hand is so good that I just want to stay alive. I'm hoping that my opponent will tap out and I can Savage Punch the Mantis Rider. Oh wow, Sagu Mahler. Okay, I'm gonna morph the Spell Snatcher. And then I'll pass the turn. I'm just gonna bounce the Knuckleblade to my hand and then recast it next turn. This game has been very strange. I'm a little bit scared that my opponent has a lot of Aerostorms or something. Perhaps I will suicide my Highland game to gain some life at some point. I'll also have Karu Spell Snatcher up at some point. My opponent has made a point to just always leave up 2 mana, which is kind of scaring me. Right, I'm gonna deploy these creatures. And then from this point forward, I'm gonna hold up the Spell Snatcher. Oh wow, my opponent's morph was Flock. That was surprising. I was expecting a Fleet Weapon Master. One Defiant Strike. Let's see if my opponent has 2 Defiant Strikes. There's the Feat of Resistance I knew you had. I hope I draw a land. Ooh, Force Away. That's also good. Right, I'm gonna go ahead and attack with all of my creatures. I already made the bluff that I had Awaken the Bear, so I'm not. It's possible my opponent makes a good block, but I think in most of the scenarios, my opponent is not going to make a great block. All right, I'm okay with this. I can just deal my opponent 8 and leave up the Spell Snatcher. I can't really imagine a way that I lose this game. My hand is so good, my board is so good. I think that I can take 4 one more time. All right. Jeskai Student is acceptable. Right, let's go ahead and. Do I need to take the Kirin? No, I really don't. I'll just unmorph the Sagu Mahler. All right, I didn't draw land for the Spell Snatcher, but that's fine. Right, that was a good block by my opponent. All right, I'm gonna gain control of the Mantis Rider. All right, my Motley Crue of rares won me this draft. Thanks for watching.